everybody. How's it going? Oh, excited to see some of this game, Bella. Thank you. I am too. We are going to be starting The Longing. For everyone who has not been involved in the last couple of hours, I'll just let you know that I was just on Beard and the Hairs podcast called Within the Beard. Wonderful chat. Great guy, good friend. It was a good time. So that episode will be up on YouTube, not this coming Friday or Saturday, but the weekend after, because he had to record Joe Medforce's, which is going to go up this weekend, and then mine. So be on the lookout for that. Go follow Beard in the Hair.
Look, everyone. Crap the Gamer Lady got herself a subscription. Gorge.
Thank you so much, Bella. I appreciate the sub for 2 months in a row. I appreciate you a lot. And the advice definitely helped about just you're nervous because you care. We were, for everyone else, we were talking about the fact that something that just is innocuous is I'm going to go bullshit with Harv about streaming for an hour and just other people will be watching. Shouldn't be stressful. But yet I was having anxiety today and I was hanging out in Bella Luna's stream. Go give her a follow if you have not already. Hubby, can you shout her out, please? She's a great streamer, does stuff like Stardew Valley, but also Little Nightmares, does game nights for the community that are really fun. Go follow her. But good advice was that you're nervous because you care. And even if you've done a certain performance a million times, the million and first time, you will still be nervous because you care about it. So anyway, that helped a lot. And thank you for that, because that definitely helped. So earlier today, there was the Nintendo Indie Direct, and that had some cool games. I was watching it with Robo Dessert in his chat, and one of the games that I saw was called The Longing, and the basic premise, I'm going to find the trailer so we can watch that, and then check it out, but the basic premise is that you're going to go through the game in 400 days in real time, because you're this little, I call him a creepy Dobby, because you look like you're Dobby from Harry Potter, but he's just a little off and dark. And you're waiting like 400 days for your master. You're like the god that you serve. You're the last one left, and you got to wait 400 days for him to wake up or whatever. So let's find the trailer and give that a watch. Let's see. Direct. Next thing we're going to do after that is we're going to go back into Final Fantasy, because I got the bug. I thought to myself, you know what? I've played Final Fantasy before. I know what this is like. No. I do remember what it's like, but it I still got the bug. So
Spiel davon machen wollte, wo man 400 Tage lang auf dieses Erwachen warten muss.
Okay, I'm trying to get to the point in the
characters take on quirky.
Okay. Let's go to this scene. I think it might already be set up for what I want to do. Hang on just a second. There we go. And I will this full scene. So right after this part, it's going to get to the part where in the direct from today where they talk about the longing. So let's go ahead and watch that so you guys can get an idea of what it's like.
Side quests and discover all the hidden secrets of this weird and gorgeous skating utopia.
This is not it.
Ride through Radland in Olly Olly World, launching on Nintendo Switch this winter.
Here we go.
Hallo, ich bin Anselm Püter von Studio Seufz aus Deutschland. Vor etwa 9 Jahren kam ich beim Wandern an eine Höhle, die mit einer alten Sage verknüpft ist. Ein alter König legte sich angeblich dort zur Ruhe und bat seinen Diener, ihn aufzuwecken, sobald die Zeit gekommen ist. Ich fand diese Geschichte so faszinierend, dass ich unbedingt ein Videospiel davon machen wollte, wo man 400 Tage lang auf dieses Erwachen warten muss. Und einige Jahre lang war dieses Spiel mein Herzensprojekt, weil ich herausfinden wollte, wie man Zeit als Spielmechanik verwenden kann, um diese Geschichte zu erzählen. Ich hoffe, ihr werdet alle Spaß haben, jetzt The Longing auf der Nintendo Switch zu spielen.
See, doesn't he look like a little cursed Dobby? So cute. In a weird way.
this hand-drawn art style. I've never seen anything like it. And wow, 400 days in real time?
You don't actually have to play this adventure game to see how it ends. But that doesn't mean you should leave this little guy all alone. This is a Shade, the last servant of a king who once ruled an underground kingdom. Explore dark caves, complete time-based puzzles, and collect items as you long for him to awaken. The longing comes to Nintendo Switch later today.
It's today. So that, oh, and this next one that they're going to show is another game that I bought. Well, we'll do that on another day. So that is what I would like to look into today. I have a feeling it's going to be one of those games where you go in kind of like Animal Crossing, where you can only do kind of so much in a day. And then you just kind of let the little guy sleep and then you go back and you visit him the next day. So, but let's see how that is. I was going back and forth on whether or not to do Stream Raiders tonight. I think I will. So I thought I opened this. Let's get it going again. Go over here to Raiders. Hey, it actually played nice in the sandbox first time. So how are you guys doing? If you're in chat and you feel like chatting, go ahead and tell me something about your day. Tell me a good thing or something positive. Or if you're having a really bad day, just be like, hey, you know, my day sucked and I'm here to be distracted. You can do that too. Or if you're on the lurk train, lurk away. Looks like we are headed into a silver chest 3 skull. Let's take a look at that. Oh, I have money. Let's go spend our money. So I need to be doing bombers and mages. I don't even know if I have mages yet. I don't even know if I have bombers yet. Okay. Let's see. I'm not going to turn on the music because it would be on for like 30 seconds before I get into this game. So let's see what we can upgrade first before we buy anything else. Definitely want to get our rogue up to 20. Oh, get a unit to level 10. 200 gold, heck yeah! That's going to upgrade a lot. Okay. So, I do have a mage, and I do have a bomber. All right. Those were the two things, right? Bomber, mage, yep. All right. Well, let's get a paladin leveled up. And flying rogue. I guess that's just a regular rogue. Upgrade you. And ten. Need to upgrade the buster. Oh, unlock it. There we go. And I think that's all I can do. Yep. All right. So let's get that started. I'm going to go ahead and put out the mage. There. And there you go. Off to Raiders Land. So now let us... Oh, I didn't add my... my new capture card source since I've switched hard drives. So let me get that in here. There it is. All right. Let's see. I got to make sure the audio is working. Yep, looks like it should be. You guys make sure if you're listening, let me know if the volume is going to be too loud or too quiet or what's going on. It's a little loud. I think that's probably okay. I was gonna say, I'm getting claustrophobic. Digging the music though. It's a good vibe. Such a cool opening. Oh, there's our little guy. My powers have faded. All I have left is you, my faithful shade. All I ask of you is to wait and never to leave these caves. Aww. I shall now sleep for 400 days to gather my remaining strength. Wake me when the time has come to end all fear and longing. I love this. Oh, now our countdown has started. Oh, so we're gonna have to like set up our home. Time is progressing slow and steady. Slow and steady. Oh, we can draw. I don't have that color. Oh, okay. So we're gonna gather colors for ourselves. I just let him go until he's done. Time goes by faster in the company of great art. This one deserves a special place on my wall. Right stick over a picture and then press A to reposition it. Okay. Cool. So we can draw artwork for our wall. Well, make music. I'll need to find all four parts of this instrument before I can enjoy the pleasure of making music. I currently have one instrument part. I love that it gives you tasks. It has begun. Yes, you've missed the first, 3 minutes and 5 seconds. 6 seconds. 7 seconds. This is really cool. Sit down and read. Nothing better than resting armchair body. Oh, the weary body on a comforting armchair. Read a book, sit and stare. The goose girl? Yeah, but he's cute though. He's kind of adorable. Thus spoke Zarathustra, Moby Dick. What's the goose girl? There was once upon a time an old queen whose husband had been dead for many years, and she had a beautiful daughter. When the princess grew up, she was betrothed to a prince who lived a great distance. When the time came for her to be married, and she had to journey forth into the distant kingdom, the aged queen packed up for her many costly vessels of silver and gold, and trinkets also of gold and silver, and cups and jewels, in short, everything... Everything which appertained to a royal dowry, for she loved her child with all her heart. She likewise sent her maid in waiting. Whoops. Her maid in waiting, who was to ride with her and hand her over to the bridegroom, and each had a horse for the journey. But the horse of the king's daughter was called Falada and could speak. So when the hour of parting had come, the aged mother went into her bedroom, took a small knife, and cut her finger with it, until it bled. Then she held it to a white handkerchief, which she let 3 drops of blood fall, gave it to her daughter and said, "Dear child, preserve this carefully. It will be of service to you on your way." I'm going to stop there. I should be reading more. Okay. Maybe that's what I have him do when I leave for the day. So what's over there? What's the little hole? Can you only go? King warned me that I... Thank you, Boney, for that sound alert. I appreciate the 500 biddies. Oh, no, that was channel points. That's right. I did that for channel points. That's right. I gotta remember which ones I have for the channel points and which ones I have for bits. I love that one. That used to be my ringtone. So the king warned me that I should never leave the caves. I wonder exactly what he meant by that. Well, maybe don't leave the caves. How are you doing, Boney? How was your day? What were you the most excited about out of the Indie Direct? Obviously, you can see I got this one. I also got the There Is No Game, because the fact that that had some kind of a story that runs through it was intriguing to me. The scary thirst trap mermaids and pirates. Yeah. I am the crafty gamer lady. Were you watching the podcast? How are you doing, Michael? How was your day? I think the king will allow me to explore his vast realm, but I better remember the way back. You missed the podcast. I think Harv said it's going to be up on a VOD, and then it's going to be uploaded to YouTube a week from Friday? Are you doing them on Fridays, Harv, or Saturday? No. Friday next week, so a week from Friday. Hello, Xeranix, how are you doing? But yeah, those scary mermaids and pirates, that scene was uncomfy. That was a little much. That's not soon enough, then watch the VOD, Michael. I talk about you. Positive things, of course. Talk about you, I talk about Hubby, I talk about Robert, I talk about Robo, I talk about pretty much everybody for a while. Because you know I like to spread the love. Press Y for auto walk. Okay. Okay, walk to a random place. Let's take a little stroll. We'll see where I end up. All right. Let's see where he ends up. So for those of you who didn't watch the Indie Direct and have no idea what we're doing, this game is called The Longing. And you see the countdown timer up at the top of the screen? That is set for 400 days. There's no need to hurry. I have plenty of time to walk. Nice. The Ollie Ollie world and Skull. His skull looked interesting. Like, can he not die because he's already a skeleton? So for the longing, this little guy, that sleeping king in the middle is the god, and he has to sleep for 400 days to get his energy back. He's out of his power. This little dude, who I call Creepy Dobby, is the only person left. Like, his shade is his only servant left. So he has to basically kill time for 400 days in, real time. That's why the clock's up there. And then on day 400, we have to go wake him up. And then I assume it's game over, man. Game over. But yeah, we already found out that our little cave where we live has something where you could... pick it up. Oh, it's a lump of coal. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna have to find stuff because it has paper that you can draw with and it has the options for different colors, but you only have black right now. So we're gonna end up finding stuff that's gonna let us color more. We're gonna be able to color more pictures in the meantime. Let's walk to another random place. We're going to have to find other stuff to decorate our room because the room, I assume we're going to find some books because there was only 3 books on the shelf, but I've seen in the trailer that the bookshelf is pretty much full. There's lights on the walls that are the crystals from somewhere in the cave. So lots of stuff that we'll be able to find and improve our quality of life, as it were. So this will be interesting. And like I said before we even started, I have a feeling this is going to be one of those games like Animal Crossing where you go in and you do a little bit of stuff every day, but then you can only really kind of play it for so long. So it'll be a good little once a day kind of zone out and, hang out with your little dude. So everyone else in chat, if you want to, tell me something about your day. Tell me something good that happened or something that you're looking forward to maybe for this weekend. What game you're into. Tell me something good. Interesting where you end up if you just follow your nose. Don't know if that means anything. Don't want to wake him up yet. We got 399 more days to go. Oh, you had a great shoot at work, relatively low-key. Nice. Yeah, I know it's not every day that you're able to, like, leave and go on a shoot. It's awesome. You got a haircut. What did you do? Is it, like, was it a big change or just, like, a maintenance haircut? Love how I'm all, like, concerned with the condition of your hair now. So, is this leaving or is this more of the caves? Oh, make a fire. I want to make a fire. Just a maintenance haircut. Okay. My fireplace. Oh, it's a fireplace. It's not a way to leave. Okay, that makes me feel better that I'm not going to, like, inadvertently try to leave the cave and ruin the game. Could use a little warmth from time to time. Okay, so this is where the coal's gonna come in. Oh, I can make a blue fire with lapis lazuli? I call it lapis lazuli. Is it lazuli? I call it lapis lazuli. I don't know. That's probably wrong. Okay. So here, this is our little room. Here, let's see if we can draw another picture just so you guys can see what I'm talking about. So we have the coal. Choose a color and a motif. So there's the black. Myself, friend. Han, soul. Cave, eye, moon. Laos. I assume we're going to find more stuff to draw later. Let's do friend. And you can just watch your little guy draw a spider. I think he's cute in a creepy way. He's called a shade. So there's kind of your taste of the game. What do you guys think? You want me to explore some more and see what else is out there? Or do you want me to jump into Final Fantasy? What do we think? There is like 11 minutes left on Raiders. If you do, the command is just a little bit further up, but you can do !Raiders and get in on that. Maybe we play until the Raiders battle and then we switch. Yeah, sounds good. All right. So I heard that my hubby told you that he is starting a new class, which I think he's doing right meow, actually. Which one did you end up picking?
I haven't yet.
You haven't yet. Okay.
I'm still kind of...
He's still mulling it over. Oh, the right stick. That's right. Right stick is how you choose things. So let's move this guy. Oh, not that one. Here we go. So let's go see what else is out there. And you obviously can't make him walk any faster. So, man, 400 days. So, you know, there's 365 days in a year. So a year from today, we're still going to have over a month left. That's nutso. But I love it. It's like the way delayed gratification. Now all I can hear in my head is Gollum. The
up, up, up the stairs we go.
I want to go up. There we go. Ooh, there's a door. I'm trying to think of what else he reminds me of, like what animation style, and there's like a little dude with the eyes like that. Oh, this door hasn't opened in a long time. It might take a while. My Joy-Cons are rumbling in my hands, for the record. So you can see the crack, like, slowly opening. This game really is about, like, delayed gratification. I'm not gonna lie though, this is like a really nice hand massage because it's just shaking away. Anything else stand out besides the longing? Yes. Hey Nard Dog, how you doing, friend? How was your day? I know you were saying earlier you were just working life away. There's one other game that I bought, Michael, called There Is No Game, and it looks like a whole bunch of little mini games that you can play, that were, you know what, we'll watch that little part of the video, because I've still got it pulled up, and it was the next thing, but there's some kind of, like, overarching story in it. There Is No Game. This ain't no game. Oh, you're taking a 4-day weekend, Nardog? Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Way to look out for yourself. Good for you. I hope you enjoy it. So does that start now, or is that like a Friday through Monday deal? Let's see what's in this little room, and then we'll backtrack. Oh, this isn't going to be a little room. This seems like a great place to be lonely. I better remember the way. Okay, yeah, I think we'll remember. So what are you? They're broken, so I wonder if I'm gonna be able to get a tool to like keep breaking that apart. And these magnificent halls is sure a fulfilling occupation. Oh, yeah, I can see how this is gonna be like a labyrinth. Oh, Giant Bomb had a video series called This Ain't No Game. Yeah, I wish I would have been more aware of Giant Bomb back in the day, like, so that I could be caught up on everything now. Oh, a lump of coal. A fallen brother is returning home. I now have 2 coal. Wow, that's deep. Oh, Boney, you remember them doing that? Yeah, I wasn't really aware of that whole world until I started listening to the Tested podcasts, because once the Mythbusters was over, I started looking for anything. Oh, yeah, with Ryan Davis. I remember listening to the Tested episode, like, when right after he had passed, and that was hard to listen to. So I was looking for anything that Adam Savage was doing, because I adore that man. And then I found the Tested channel, and I was listening to his podcast, which used to be called Still Untitled. I forget what it's called now because I haven't kept up on it because I don't drive anywhere anymore. What?
No, just giggling at your...
Giant Bomb Premium, you've access to all the archive content? Awesome. Is that video content or audio or both? because I can see myself getting into the video, but like I said, with audio, I have an hour drive to work when I go, when I do work in the office. So that's how I was consuming all of my pod. It's still called the Untitled Adam Savage Project. All right. That's how I would consume all of my audio or my podcast content, but I don't drive anymore. I haven't driven for like a year unless it's to go to the church when he's working. But so I was listening to his podcast, and then I realized that Tested had another podcast. This is only a test. And so I started listening to that from the very beginning. And then that's when they were still with, I don't know if they were still in the Whiskey Media offices, I think. And then soon afterwards is when they like split off into their own office. I thought they came up for a name for it, Michael, in the last, like, 3 or 4 months. Yeah, after being home and not keeping up on the podcast, they ended it in January? Like, ended it? Or did it switch over to whatever the other name was? Hey, Jezebu, how's it going? How you doing, friend? I saw you just set up a new art site for yourself. I was gonna go check that out a little later. Is it just a place to, like, consolidate all your artwork? Artful, it's a new app. Okay. About a little less than 2 minutes on Raiders. We're gonna get this little guy back in his house and reading a book, and then we'll switch to Raiders. No! After 8 years of recording the pod, we're refocusing our energies on something new. Dang it! Since most artists are sick of Twitter and Instagram and their shitty algorithms, a lot of people are trying something new. I may take a look at that then. Because maybe that can be the place, because I'm doing like a multifaceted thing that's gaming and artwork, I still want to have a place where if people want to go check out my artwork, they can go to that thing instead of having to weed through all of my Instagram posts. Even if I make an album, you know, that's artwork, still, it'd be nice to just have that separate and in one place. So I will definitely check that out. All right. Little dude, let's get you comfy and reading a book. Here, read a book. He's so creepy, I love it. Yeah, I know, Reagan, he's so cute. I'm trying to think of what he reminds me of besides Dobby. Like, there's a specific, I don't know if it's something from like Where the Sidewalk Ends or those. No, it's like a specific, I'm pretty sure it's got to be something from that type of thing, like Where the Sidewalk Ends, and I can't remember the name of the author. So that art app, it's a bit rough at the moment since so many people are jumping on quickly. It's only an app on Android and iOS at the moment, but a lot of us are hoping for a PC version. Gotcha. A Roald Dahl character. Yeah, exactly. Hey, Avenged. How you doing, sweetie? Reminds me of a kid's book. Yeah. Michael, I think you're spot on. All right, I heard the Raiders thing go off. Let's get him reading a book. You can do idle reading. Yay, so he can read without me. Idle reading. Okay. So I'm going to leave him to that. And we will go over to Raiders, and then we will jump into some Final Fantasy. I'm doing well, Avenged. We had... This sword is so pretty. Yes, I gave you a sword. And you're welcome. You're an excellent mod. All of my mods are excellent mods and very much appreciated. Stream Raiders. So, I don't remember what I was saying. Oh, we'll look at that. You're not questionable. We'll look at the rest of that the next part of the video that shows the other game I was talking about from the Indie Direct today. So, but let's start our battle. We've got 13 units on the field. Hubby, can you get Raiders up on your phone, please? He's trying to figure out what other class he wants to switch to in Final Fantasy, so I can't be too upset. We're slaughtering them anyway. It's fine. It's fine. Boom. All right, let us choose. I'm going to give this to Miss Bella Luna, who has the most units on the field. Thank you, ma'am. Good. See, now I can move it, and I want the most for the viewers instead of me. So, grant rewards. You are welcome. Next thing, oh, we got to decide. So we can either do a loyalty boss chest, good chance of rare scrolls, or 10 plus gold drops. Viewers unlock more loyalty chest rewards as they win more battles with you. So that's a level 5 boss. Or one that is still a loyalty boss chest, but it is a mystery of what we fight. So what do you guys want to do? Do you want to do the enemy that we know or the enemy that we don't? I am going to redeem a hydrate on myself. Mystery? I like a good mystery. Anyone else want to weigh in? I have been talking a lot today. For those that missed it, I was honored to be on Harv's podcast, Within the Beard. We sat and talked about streaming today for over an hour, and it was a very good podcast, a very good time. He said that the VOD would be up, but then the edited video is going to be up on YouTube a week from Friday, because Joe Medforces is going to be out this Friday, and then me. So, hearing none else, let's do the mystery battle. And 5 skulls. I'm going to put out... Oh, thank you, Reagan. I appreciate that. Except when I couldn't figure out whether it was you or... Avenge, were you the one that said... Shit, what was it? What did I get confused about, Reagan? But who said what? Oh, that we all have social anxiety, but that streaming gives us control over like one little part of our day. Was that you, Avenged? See, I had to do mages and bombers. Was that right? Where's the bomber at? Buster, rogue. Oh, it's this dude. Yeah, let's put this guy out. Siamese Snow got one on the field. CGL Hubby, me. You guys can do exclamation point Raiders in the chat to bring that up. Okay. So let us... switch over to Final Fantasy. Get that going. Guys, we did it. We made it past the halfway point of the week. We just got to knock out Thursday and Friday. Ooh. Has anyone heard from Scooter yet about whether or not he got his promotion? I kept checking Twitter, and eventually I had to tell him, like, will you quit tweeting, replying to other people about stuff? Because every time I see a notification that you tweeted, I gasp. I don't see anything. For those that don't know, Scooter Cannon has been pulling back on his streaming schedule this week because he has been preparing a, and last week, preparing a big presentation to do for his work that would, how dare Scooter confer- I know, right? Rude. I only want to hear about his job promotion. Big presentation to give that, and then his bosses were going to meet or something and then decide on a promotion. And his boss said it went well, but he has not heard, like, for sure yet. Thank you for the lurk, Bella. I appreciate you. I loved your stream earlier. It was very zen, chill, exactly what I needed today. Thank you so much. So we're all just, like, waiting to hear about it. Don't you even. When are you down for maintenance? April 15th. Okay, see? 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. That's a perfectly reasonable time to go down for maintenance. 6 p.m.? Not a good time to go down for maintenance. Okay. But we're good for now. I don't know why I panicked because my husband's right over there playing on the same world that I'm going to be on. By the way, Michael, I couldn't get into the one that I thought it was going to let me get into. I had to get into Coral, just like Hubby. What?
You know what's funny about that is the message that you got just now when you were coming in?
Yeah.
It's about not being able to visit different world servers.
Oh.
I'm currently on Marlboro. I literally can't get back to my home server.
Oh, no. As long as it is the Crystal Data Center. Yeah, I know. Hello, Pontotonic. How are you doing? How was your day? How are you feeling? I know you were going to recharge your batteries. Hope you're getting some rest and zoning out. I don't know if you guys heard my husband, but he had traveled to Marlboro. I think when he was playing with you, Michael, the maintenance that they're doing is about traveling between worlds. He literally cannot get back right now. He's stuck there. So that's what he's doing. So let's see. Trying to recharge. Oh, feeling very demotivated to stream. You know, that's one thing. I don't know if you were watching my the podcast that I recorded a little while ago with Beard and the Hair, but we were kind of talking about motivation and burnout and everything. That is a mood. It's a big mood. And sometimes you got to give yourself like a week, you know, of just having some downtime and getting your batteries charged. Sometimes you might only need like a day or two. But you shouldn't feel bad about it because everyone in this community understands they want us to take care of ourselves and recharge and enjoy what we're doing. Let me get to the actual game, shall I? So, oh, hey, that worked first time. Look at that. You guys are going to have to tell me if the game sounds are good. Right now it looks kind of quiet. You feel like you want a purpose to stream beyond just playing games. I don't know how to make streaming meaningful. What I was talking about with Beard was kind of along the same things. You have the streamers who will just want to play games, and that's fine. And then you have the ones that are more involved with like their community and like wanting to do community games, getting them involved in chat, us talking back and forth right now, just like this, doing like channel point redemptions, setting goals. So maybe what I would suggest doing is take a few days, take the rest of the week and think about why you want to stream. Do you want to just share games with people? Do you want to have a community? Do you want to teach people how to do something like I'm going to be doing the art streams and stuff, and then set some goals for yourself and then make those clear to your audience through not just on the stream, but like on social media where it can be like permanently recorded. And then help, like work together with your viewers and with your crew, with your community and start hitting those goals together. But make it something that's fun for you, something that you enjoy doing. Don't try to fit yourself into a little streamer box of like, this is what a streamer should be. So if I had any advice, it would be that. I know you and I had talked, texted a little bit about wanting to do some kind of like a fundraiser thing. Maybe that would be a good way to like kick off something to bring folks together. And then you can take that event and go from there with whatever direction you want to go in. So that's, but yeah, don't feel bad about taking time to step back and like reevaluate and think about where you want to go. Cause that's, we all want us to take care of ourselves and enjoy what we're doing. So thank you for coming to my TED Talk. You're very welcome. And you're not alone in that. We all, and Dolphin has some very good advice. Enjoy some cherry limeade. If you guys have not tried Zyance, I highly recommend it. This is the mango guava. There's cherry lime, there's a fruit punch, there's a blueberry pomegranate, but it only has 15 calories and there's sodium in it and 5 carbs, but everything else, there's no fat, there's no, no added sugar as far as I know. Yeah, it's like carbonated water and then, you know, the flavors and all that kind of stuff. But there's even like vitamins, there's caffeine in it. So it's a little bit of an energy drink. Game change. I did. Oh, on the stream. Hey, Michael, you want to be a mod and change the game for me? You do exclamation point set game, all one word, and then a space and then Final Fantasy. Thank you, Harf. Yeah, so this is good. The cherry limeade's good. Did that not work? Oh, yeah, it did work. Yep. Right? Yep, that worked. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Now I gotta get my Streamlabs back. There we go. Oh, they finally had the mango guava. You just tried the... Oh, the AHA. I saw you post about that. Pop rocks in my mouth. That was in a Discord, wasn't it, Pontotonic? Weird drink, but tastes amazing. Does it taste bitter or is it still kind of sweet? Because I tried like a citrusy tea type drink, but it was just really bitter and like dry tasting. Oh, you're talking about the homemade cherry limeade, Dolphin. That does sound good. It's easy and delicious. The citrus green tea caffeine version was sweet. I may have to try that because that's why I found Zyance, is because I'm trying to find like the more natural stuff to get my energy from. I actually had my hubby pick up my drink from our coffee shack on the way home because I'm almost wondering if I shouldn't have no caffeine. Because I had been having like my drink every day and then maybe like also a coffee. And I didn't have any headaches or anything coming off of it, but now, like, with my medication, I feel like it's almost wanting that buffer, because I get, like, these, like, jolts of nerve activity that's almost my brain being like, there's something missing, you just gotta, like, where's the caffeine? Like, it's really weird to explain, but, so I may try having something in the morning now and seeing if that kind of tempers that. So, yeah. Yeah, it is. So, all right. Enough of my yammering. Let's get into the game and see what we gotta do. I am gonna go ahead now and just drive through the storyline quests and not pick up all the little side ones so we can kind of level up faster. What do you mean the world's full? I mean, there's only 37 players in queue, but we'll sit here and talk, I guess. Don't worry. Yeah, I'll get in. I love coffee, but feels too much sometimes, so the AHA drink was a perfect substitute. Yeah, so I love this drink, because it is, what is it called? Lotus. This is a pink Lotus, and it's like the all-natural type energy drink. See, there we are. And then it does have strawberry syrup and almond syrup and some white chocolate in it. But the rest, it's just club soda. And then I also have a couple of pumps of a CBD elixir in here. And I think that's what kind of, like, tempers everything. So, I don't know. If I do have a coffee drink lately, it's been the Starbucks, the double shot mocha in a can. So. All right. Take you away. All right, so now I have to, Purger, I love it! He made a Horp emote, and it's rainbow colored, and it's sparkly! So sparkly! Oh, you're out of sugar, Dolphin, I'm sorry. Do you have any honey or agave syrup? I gotta find it. Hang on. There it is. Oh my goodness. I love it. It's so pretty. Did she consult with you on that, Purger? Or did you just do that like to like surprise her? Or does she not even know about it? I love it. I love it so much. You're going to pop out to the store, Dolphin? Okay, sounds good. I will likely still be here. Honey won't work for the limeade? All right. Oh, she got to do the whole thing. Nice. So it's like her emote, even though she's not a streamer. I love that. Pontotonic heading to bed because you have to work in the morning. But yeah, we'll talk later offline. Definitely, for sure. You have a great night too, sweetie. I hope you get some good rest and can just kind of check out for a little while. I appreciate you a lot. All right. And Purger, how are you doing? How's your day been going? All right. D's away. So for those that were not here when Baba Booey Incorporated, jeez. For those that weren't here when I... Those are Easter eggs. Okay. That's a lot of Easter eggs. I've never seen that before. That is hilarious, and I love it. These weren't here yesterday, or I'm completely blind. Hectic, honestly. Glad you weren't streaming tonight. Oh no, has it just been like recovering from any time you took off from your family being there? Or is there like actually egg tile in the? Oh my gosh, they did like, I don't think those are quite Fabergé eggs, but those are so cool. And like there's eggs hanging from the ceiling. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. And look at the banners everywhere. I've never seen them do something like this before. They didn't used to do this. I adore that. And look at the lamps. I don't know if those are always eggs, but they are so cute. Yeah, this was not here yesterday. I swear on my life. Thank you for the lurk, Purger. I appreciate it. New event. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, but it is super adorable. Okay. But we got work to do. So we are going to run outside. So this is Malorian. She is a Thaumaturge, Eorzean. She's purple and she's gothic-y. How can I see your like full size? Can I do that? Other than like, there we go. So that's my girl. She's got purple hair with red highlights. Good suggestion. She's got the ear clamps, purple lipstick, red eyes. And she is badass. So we are off to save the world. And right now we're going to do that by going and speaking with Papa Sean out in the dispatch yard. I think the scroll lock button hides the UI. Oh, for like taking pictures and stuff. Yeah, I'm good for now, but I'll try that when the scene changes. Yep, you are correct. Thank you for that. I might actually take a picture of her and post it. Did I go out the right gate? I did. Yeah, so the yard is over here. Oh, so now we have our hunting log, so I can start knocking these out. So, and again, for those of you that weren't here before to hear my Final Fantasy backstory, I had played with my husband and a group of our friends that we'd been gaming with for a long time, right when A Realm Reborn came out, we played for a good couple of years, and then we just kind of moved on to other things. But now that we've seen Michael playing it and my hubby had the itch to get back into it, I'm going to get back into it. So I just restarted my character on a different world, and we're going to try to get to the end of the story before the new content comes out. So, JD, how are you doing? How was your day? We tried out The Longing a little bit ago from the Indie Direct, and that's such a cute little creepy game. Don't know if you guys saw the Indie Direct, those of you that work during the day, but I would go give it a watch. Oh, I didn't. Hang on. We got to go watch the one that I didn't show you. So sorry. Nope, not that. Did I close it? I think I closed it. We'll get back there. Sleepy, gotta stop staying up until 1 a.m. when I wake up at 6. Dude, I fell asleep in my recliner last night for like the 85th night in a row at probably 1 o'clock in the morning. I woke up at 5:15 and like tried to get up and go to bed, but rather than, I was too tired to get up and go to bed, but I was too awake to not do anything. So I just stayed awake and started working early and tried to get some stuff done, and that didn't work either. So I've had a weird day, and I'm trying to like back my sleep schedule down. Nintendo Indie Direct. I want to show because we were talking about. Oh, it's gonna leave off in the same spot. Let me switch to the screen. I want to show you guys this other game that I got that we'll try. Don't get sorry, get even, or something like that. Don't do the same thing I do. Yeah, I hate those days. Yeah, that has become my life. Horp, where? Or are you just talking about the emote, Reagan? Yeah, Horp has her own emote now, and I love it. This is where I wanted to go. Waking up hours early and starting work early because fuck it. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Okay, let's...
The last servant of a king who once ruled an underground kingdom. Explore dark caves...
Okay, it's going to get to the other game here in a second. This is the one we tried today.
As you long for him to awaken.
If you missed it, this game, you go through it in 400 days in real time as the only servant of a god who has to sleep.
There is no game.
This is the other one I got.
All right, then?
No, really. The game is actually called There Is No Game. It's a point-and-click comedy adventure filled with riddles and puzzles. There's a broader story here in this non-game as well. Let's not ruin the fun, though. Just know this. If you're looking for something different, something experimental that's full of surprises, then look no further.
There Is No Game Wrong Dimension launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
So that's the other one that I got that I'm interested in. Let me see if there was anything else that I had of note. This one looked interesting and had good music. So Robo actually played the demo.
Home or on the go.
The music is
please
just
enjoy this
wah.
At Aerial Knife Never Yields.
Good jazzy vibe. Sounds good, Jezebu. Have fun with the lesson planning. Good luck with the lesson planning. Appreciate you dropping in and out. I can see myself getting addicted to that. Tell me that's not how you'd want to wake up every morning. So that one looked good. It's literally like it's a side-scrolling game where you have to either jump mid, high, or low, and it gets faster, and there's more obstacles in the way, and you're just listening to that bop like the whole time, and it looks good. I could see playing a little bit of that every once in a while when I just need to like zone out. Those ones look sad, like we're all gonna cry. I don't think it's in rhythm. I think it's just happens to have a really good soundtrack behind it. I don't want my husband to find out about this because I'm gonna hear about it until it comes out, but this looks completely badass. Yeah. He is going to lose his mind when he sees this. Yeah, I'm a little concerned, Michael, because there was a disclaimer down at the bottom here that says gameplay not final. But I mean... Yeah.
Whoa. Did we just...
So that one looks pretty good. Oh, is this the, where's the Aztec one? It's this one, I think. Yeah, check out this artwork. Not this, but what comes next. It's like half Fortnite, half like Zelda? Like modern, like, or like future tech meets Aztec. Yeah.
If you're looking for a grand adventure, look no further than Aztec Forgotten Gods. It tells the story of Ashley, a courageous woman who battles colossal demons.
Look at this.
The game
Come
puts
on.
Aztec mythology and futuristic technology front and center.
As Ashley, you'll gain powerful arm upgrades, traverse different areas within a modern Mesoamerican
Come
metropolis,
on.
And encounter all sorts of characters to uncover ancient secrets. However, sometimes the truth is best left forgotten. Aztec Forgotten Gods soars onto the Nintendo Switch system fall 2021.
That's on my list. Skull, this is the one that Boney was talking about. Let's see where the trailer for it actually starts. We were talking about the Reaper's probably gonna love this one too. He is avenged. Holy cow. Yeah.
Skull the Hero Slayer is a 2D fast-action roguelite where you take on an entire army to rescue your king. And the best part? To progress in the game, you'll need to swap abilities, which is done by swapping heads.
Oh, I didn't catch that part.
I mean heads, each with their own special abilities, plus numerous items and upgrades, there are certainly enough possibilities here to make your head spin.
So get a head. Literally, in Skull the Hero Slayer.
Yeah.
Launching on Nintendo Switch, summer 2021.
It's because they're the new hotness, Michael.
We're nearing the end of today's showcase. Before we go, there are several...
Let's see if there was anything else that caught my eye. Some of these weren't all that, like... Oh, this was the one more thing portion. And I'd never heard of the first one, so it didn't really grab my attention. But everyone else has been talking about it all day, so... This looks very not Nintendo.
Can you hear me?
But I'm kind of here for it.
Riley, are you there?
She done just chopped a tree in half. Oh, Oxenfree 2. That's what it was. Oh, that's not creepy at all. Yeah, so the first one was Oxenfree. This is Oxenfree 2. And yeah, it looks very intriguing. It also looks very not Nintendo to me for some reason. But, you know, whatever. And also, this is the demo for Balan Wonderworld. I downloaded the demo under Robo's recommendation because it's actually getting pulled from the stores because it's so terrible. And he's like, download the demo and like... play it before you can't because it's you have to know how awful it is. Like, it's just not a good game apparently, so yikes. We've got 40 seconds until Raiders. If you want to put down a last unit, I will flip over there, we'll do a battle, and then we'll go back to Final Fantasy, you know, the game that I said I'd be playing. There we go. Didn't love the first one. Was it kind of similar looking in nature? Did it have like a similar vibe, or is it like totally different? I had never heard of it. I kind of want to go see a trailer for the first one. Yeah, playing games. I'm adorable. That's funny. I'm adorable. Similar? Okay. Yeah, we don't do that as a streamer. Nope. All right. I didn't hear any noises. I don't know if you did, but... all right, we've got 25 on the field. Got Siamese Snow, Crafty and Me, Bella, Michael, Froze King Jokers, Jezebu, and Xdobi. The font is really little, really far away, so I apologize for the names. Just didn't love the story and the gameplay was boring. It's disappointing. Well, these are indie games. To be fair. Look at Siamese Snow just kicking ass and taking names. All right, crew, good job. Open it and split the rewards. All right. Anyone, to be fair, I still haven't actually watched the show. I just know the reference. So we have two Musketeer Scrolls. Is there anyone in chat who is really just jonesing for Musketeer Scroll? Speak now or forever hold your peace while I hydrate. I am going to be tweaking the channel point redemptions and adding some more things, but the other ones are still there. So, Musketeers going once, Musketeers going twice, random. Michael and Bella, thank you guys so much. I think the next one, oh, yep, boss defeated. hold my peas. Not a big fan of them. All right, we are on a new map. Let's do at least one more. It looks like the bottom path is going to be more interesting. We've got a couple of like treasure trove chests. We've got some mysteries. The top path looks a little underwhelming. So let's go this way. So challenge level unknown, unknown rewards, unknown number of bosses. So. Allons-y! Love that so much. I'm to the point, we've been rewatching the Doctor Who, starting with Eccleston, with the Ninth Doctor. I'm to the point now in the Tenth Doctor where it's gonna switch over to the 11th one. And I don't wanna. All right, back to Final Fantasy. I don't wanna go. No, don't break my heart, Michael. Why is there no music? Yeah, I know. I don't want to go through that right now. Yeah. I'm still traumatized from Before Your Eyes. I don't know if I can handle the 10th Doctor switching to the 11th right now. Is there just not music right now? Guess there's just not music right now. So, having said that, we'll see, because what happens after I get to this dude and start talking to him. Oh, the command in the chat that you see right now, I gotta remember to talk about this. On Friday night at 9 o'clock Pacific, myself and Harv and Athok, Norza, and a couple other guys are gonna be on an Overwatch team, and we are playing against Reagan's team, Horror Stones, I believe. I can't remember who all's on her team. But it's part of the NTO tournaments, the new Twitch order, and we're gonna be playing off together. Same group that did the Fall Guys tournament, but just different people signed up. So that's gonna be Friday at 9. I will probably be streaming my gameplay, probably. But that link that you see in the chat, which you can also access by doing, I think it's !AAPI. It's the organization that we're raising money for is Stop AAPI Hate, and that's Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders, specifically in America. Since that has been on the rise since COVID-19, we're wanting to collect money to donate to the organization that helps identify and help stop, especially those areas where that kind of hate crime against those types of individuals is on the rise, because am I right? Yeah. So if you are able to donate at all between now and I think like the end of the month, because this is just the first round And then there's two other teams that have to play against each other. And then I think the winning team of each of those two teams is going to play off. So it's going through the whole end of the month. So you'll see that command come up in my chat. If you want to learn more, you can click on that link, or if you want to donate at any point. So, all right. I have been reading the story since the font is small. So here we go. Well, you certainly look the part of the adventurer, my friend. Might you be the good soul Momodi advised me to expect, There's the music. I am Papa Sean, station master of this humble dispatch yard. An empty title, I assure you. I truly am no more than a tired old Lalafell passing his final years in quiet and solitude. 12 know there have been plenty of both of these last 5 years since the calamity struck. The devastation was vast. Yeah, I know. Yet now true Uldans work together, doing all in our power to rebuild what was laid to ruin. By the sweat of our brows and the love of our home, we have rebuilt Ulda to the grandeur and the majesty that you see today. The railways which run through this dispatch yard, too, were born of the noble efforts of a great many souls. But there is still much work to be done. The wounds left by the calamity run deep. Isolated areas beyond our lines of supply remain, and there are places yet wanting for relief and restoration. Uldan needs the aid of you and your brethren, friend. In fact, never has our need been more dire. Which brings me to the point, I suppose. I do believe I may have some work suited to one of your ability. It's all classes. You know I want them thigh-high boots. Love that sound. I need to make that a sound alert. That's what I... Michael, can you DM me Final Fantasy theme? And I'm gonna make that a sound alert. Yes, Boney, I'm playing NPC. I had played from like 2013 to 2015 when Realm Reborn first came out, and then played for a couple years, and I haven't come back to it since, so this is all I know. So restarting again. All right. Since you've come all this way, perhaps you can perform an errand for me. It just so happens a number of sentries have been sent to guard the area. A dispatch to the dispatch yard, as it were. They have long been away from the shade of feather beds of the city. The hot days and cold nights can play hells on the mind and body out here. It isn't much, but go and give them these twilight pretzels, would you? I find comfort food always helps when I feel like killing myself. Oh dear, that got dark. So, gotta go deliver pretzels and cheer people up. The common foot soldier would have feather beds. Yeah. Forget what this one does. Oh, it swaps it. Okay. So for those that don't know, the fire, you have two kinds of spells right now. You have the fire and the ice. The fire, as it builds up and charges more, it does more damage, but it zaps your MP. And then if you switch to the cold, it doesn't do as much damage, but it restores your MP. So you kind of got to keep going back and forth. Oops, why am I doing that? I got to stop being a completionist and trying to complete everything. Right now I'm just thinking about the hunting logs, but I'm probably not going to be focusing on that. Wait, halt, madam. I'm going to have to ask you to put the pretzel on the ground and place your hands above your head. I'm glad you're doing well, Boney. Hunting log is worth the XP. Okay. Oh, you got a Zoom meeting to host. Sounds good, Dolphin. Thank you for stopping by. Hand over the pretzel. State your name and business. A Twilight Pressel from Papashan. By the gods, forgive me. You could say this new post has my nerves in a twist. I'm terribly sorry for that. Yes, well, you may rest assured that the dispatch yard is safe so long as I stand watch. Please give Papashan my thanks and tell him that I only wish I could repay the favor. Is this where all the night owls hang, I see? Tonight, apparently, yes. Which is just fine with me. I love seeing all my friends. Yeah, Avenged is everywhere. I've seen her setup and it is damn impressive. I need to get a third monitor that I can, just one that will be nice and relatively inexpensive that I can do in portrait mode behind my left monitor to have chat, and then I can also have more streaming windows like Avenge does, but not as many. I don't think I can multitask that much, at least not while I have a day job. Western front clear, Eastern front clear. Yeah, right now my monitors are too big to swing portrait mode for what I want to do, but I just need a little one for a chat box. Excuse me. For me? From Papashan? A Twilight Pretzel. My favorite. How did he know? Can't fight on an empty stomach now, can I? Actually, I can't fight on any stomach. I suppose you could say I have no stomach for fighting. That's encouraging. OBS in portrait mode is so good. Yeah, I'm waiting to see if Scooter, after he finds out about whether he got that promotion or not, if he will be able to get that video out about how to switch from Streamlabs to OBS. Because I kind of got halfway there and then I just, like, my brain shut down. And I'm sure I could figure it out, but I'd much rather be a guinea pig for their video and see if I had any questions lacking, that, like, information lacking up from it to give them feedback on. So I think I'm just gonna wait. 12 save me. Scorching days, freezing nights, this post will be the end of me. A Twilight Pretzel. Don't mind if I do. Ah, now that's a refreshing God's damn pretzel. I feel reborn. Ding. Yeah, Avenged, I was this close, but then I thought, you know what? I'm just gonna wait and use their video, like I'll be a test subject for their video. So if I still have any questions, I will definitely reach out to you because I know you'd be more than happy to help. So, a realm reborn by the power of friendship and pretzels. Forget not everybody's on the same time as me, so maybe it's too early for night owls. It's almost 9 o'clock, so we're kind of almost getting there. You're also talking to someone who fell asleep in her recliner at 2 a.m. for like the last 2-3 weeks, at least. Midnight for Avenged, yeah. Midnight for Michael. You've returned, and with a deal fewer pretzels, I see. Tell me, how fare our Sultan sworn sentries? Did they have anything to report? Anything at all? What? Nothing? Are you sure? Oh dear. Take this for your troubles, then, and stay a moment. There is more I would ask of you. Let's see. Ooh. I always found the name Bastard Sword funny. It makes me giggle, and I don't know why. Ah, staff. A bone staff. Ha! Bony. It's a bone staff. And all right. So let's get that forget what the command was. See myself out on your account? No, come back. Or are you actually going to bed? Before you go to bed, tell me how to get my, never mind. I'm good. All right, new staff. Ooh, fancy. It's party. Sleep is for the weak. Yes! Yes, Michael. Let's come to the dark side. Malorian, I have just this moment. No. No time for the concealment is... What? The time for concealment is past. The truth is, even before I had you deliver those pretzels, I was privy to some more unsettling news. Which is the real reason I sent you to meet those Sultan Sworn. Gee, you think? A young noblewoman from a very prestigious family has run away from home, and I have been ordered to see her safe return. The Sultan Sworn you met earlier are assisting with the search. Alas, it seems they have found no trace of her. I apologize for not being frank with you from the start, but we must proceed with caution. Should word of her disappearance spread, I fear others with less honorable motives may join the hunt. And should we allow her to come to any harm, not even 100 beheadings would be punishment enough. Oh dear. This cannot happen, Malorian. It must not. I need you to help me find her. Mm-hmm. Praise the 12, I knew I could count on you. Yeah, I know, and I know it's probably, for some reason, I think that all of the little Olafels have like a toad voice, but I know they're not gonna, and it's gonna piss me off, but this is what I got, man. I've instructed the others to expand the search, but Thanalan is vast and there are only so many of us. The young noblewoman's name is Lady Lilra? Those are a lot of faraway letters. I want you to go south and look for her in the vicinity of Sultan Tree. Good luck. No judgment, I just love it. Yeah. Oh, I know. I'm also not used to doing voices. Like, I tried to do the, because, you know, with the thaumaturge, you have, like, the five little Lalafels. And I assigned them all a different voice for the first lines I spoke, and then I had to go around to all of them again. I was like, ah, shit. I can't remember. So now all the Lalafels get the same voice. It's fine. All right, so now we're going to go find this chick that ran away from home, and now a bunch of people are going to be after her. Ooh, dinosaur. Oh no, it's a chocobo. I don't know why now, I like everything I see like that is a velociraptor to me. If you guys have not, Avenged, are you still here? That is totally fine. I will do it myself, since I know that he won't. Please do me a favor and go follow Michael if you're not already. Not only is he a very entertaining streamer to listen to while he's like talking through the game and the sassy comments that are my life, but he just got the other, like a week ago when he was doing Final Fantasy, a purple T-Rex mount that flies. And it's so cute. And I named her Sprinkles. So if you want to see that, you want to watch the Final Fantasy streams. But he is also going through Life is Strange. Started that yesterday. I still need to watch the end of the VOD to see what happened. But also now on Friday nights is going through You Would Die for Sprinkles. Yes. I'm happy to hear that. She took so long to get. How many times did you have to go through that dungeon? Like 5, 6? Resident Evil 7 is on Friday nights, and it is both terrible and awesome at the same time. Seven times? Yeah. No. All right, this is going to be a whole thing, so here we go. You're about to enter an instance battle, blah, 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 blah. Proceed.
Oh, Sultan Tree, hallowed spirit of my line, forgive my weakness. My failings have cost us dear.
See, a tiny little voice. Ten minutes on Raiders.
Show yourself.
As you command, O Lilira.
Ooh, they're showing new footage of RE8 tomorrow. Are you going to show it on at the beginning of your stream? I hope you do.
Forgive my selfish desire to assure your welfare.
I don't recall requesting an escort. Simply pretend we never met and continue on your way.
Oh, spoilers from the seventh one, you mean? Or spoilers for the eighth one?
We both know I can do no such thing. It isn't safe for you here alone. It isn't safe for anyone. Not with this etheric disturbance. It's as though the dead are watching us. And I'd prefer not to join them, if it's all the same to you.
8 is a direct sequel to 7. No, because it doesn't sound obvious, because I know some of them are like their own little stories, right? I mean, the only other one I watched besides this was Boney, I think, played the second one. And I think that's the only other one I've seen, but it was very different with different characters. So, as far as I know.
Ah, you must be the one the Papa Shan mentioned. Congratulations on finding our elusive young charge. You'll have to forgive her impetuousness. What she lacks in discipline, she makes up for in stubbornness.
By the way, can you guys hear that okay? Is the volume fine?
You should return with us. The station master will be eager to thank Lady Lilira's protector in person.
Okay.
Alas, the station master will have to wait. Dear Lilira, for my sake, please stay out of harm's way. As for you, dear friend, for Lilira's sake, please stay in harm's way.
They do. I don't think I got that far, so that's interesting. All right, here we go. Oops, wrong one. I love that it's all pink and purple from coming from my staff.
Thank you.
I'll take a look at it in a minute. Oh, you're right. This is the first time I've really done this much combat. Yeah, I will. Thank you for saying something. I wasn't even paying attention. Yeah, this is the first time I've done the big combat. It's huge before now, just been the little stuff. Can I pause this? No, it's not gonna. Okay. I'll deal with it after I'm done. Yeah, nope. There we go. Did it just start doing that when the combat started, or was it the whole cutscene? From the jump, okay. It looks okay now. So yeah, it just must be the super intense stuff. Say the whole intro sequence broadcasted fine.
Here.
Yeah. She's so pretty. Yeah, let's look up her skirt. That's fine. Oh, I didn't put on my boots. Gotta remember to do that.
So hath darkness risen up in its stead, presaging an end to life. For the sake of all, I beseech thee, deliver us from this fate. The power to banish the darkness dwelleth in the crystals of light. Journey forth and lay claim to them.
Aw, gee, a raid! Welcome, everyone! Welcome to Crafty Gamer Lady Stream!
Hello, Gamer Earth Jen! How are you doing? And welcome, Raiders! Hello, hello! We are going through Final Fantasy XIV, and I think this cutscene's just about to end. For those of you that don't know, I'm Crafty Gamer Lady. Michael, would you mind giving Gamer Earth Jen a shout-out, please? I am doing well. What were you doing? What was your stream? This is a beautiful cutscene. You were doing before your eyes. Did you finish it? That is such... Oh, mwah, that game. Love, love, love that game. Yeah, so now she's going to wake up. I had played Final Fantasy like from 2013 to 2015. And now it will pause. And we got only so far, and then my gaming group kind of wandered away from it. But now we want to, now that like Michael's playing it and my husband wanted to get back into it, we're starting over and going to go all the way through all the content until the new stuff comes out. Talked about nature for a bit. Ooh, what about nature were you talking about? And then before your eyes, you're in the middle of it. Yes. It's kind of turned blinking into an exercise though. Yeah. One of us. Yeah, and Michael was just saying, and I fully agree, I'm not ending my stream yet, but all I want to do right now is play video games, but I gotta sleep so I can do a job, so I can live, and then continue the cycle. Life's BS. I completely agree. Nature news, history of national parks, since National Park Week is coming up. Oh, that's awesome. I love that you do that. It is so cool to have that kind of stream out there. I love that a lot. Yeah, you are just gonna love how this keeps progressing through before your eyes, and I'm not gonna say anything else about it. Zip. Did you see Robo Desserts, stream of when he did that game? If you haven't, and I say this for your viewers as well, after you have finished the game, you should go watch the end of his VOD, or he posted a clip of it on Twitter. He played it on the day that it released, I think it was the day that it released. And we got all the way through the game, and I won't tell you what kind of an emotional state we were in, but it was intense. And then as the credits were rolling, we found out the devs had been in his stream the entire time and just loved the way that everyone was reacting to his gameplay and us in chat and everything. And it was just a magical, magical Twitch moment. So once you and your viewers have experienced the rest of the game, go give that clip a watch. They were in your stream tonight too. They just like, they must be on it. I love that so much that they're involved with their players like that. I love it. I love it. I love it. Yeah, oh, that is such a special game. Yeah, you're gonna love it, and that's all I'm gonna say about it, because I don't want to ruin anything. You're surprised, yeah. All right, so I'm gonna keep going through this cutscene here. Again, this is very early game in the first in A Realm Reborn. So yeah, finish it next week if you can. Yeah, sounds good. Sounds good. Well, welcome in. If you guys wanna stay and lurk, please go for it. I'm just going to play for a little while longer here.
Would you mind telling me what that was?
I didn't finish my spiel, but if you don't know me, I am a variety game streamer. I do need to fix the frame rate still. Can I do that now? No. This is the first time I've streamed a battle, and the frames were kind of dropping a little bit, but I'm going to fix it. What was I going to say? Oh, variety gaming. So I do anything from like Animal Crossing to Final Fantasy to Mario games to fill in the blank. But I also do art streams. I do drawing. I do painting. I do mosaics. I'm going to do some crochet later. And eventually throughout the year, I'm going to be starting to teach like art classes and those kind of a things. So if you're interested in learning how to do some different kind of arts and stuff, go ahead and leave a follow, and you can see when I'm going to be offering some classes. You can also hop in the Discord and be looking out for that kind of news to be coming later on. But yeah, there's me. All right, so we'll go through, and then I'll change the frame rate here, or the quality.
The void
at any rate.
The void sent? Yeah, but how?
The question isn't how, but who. We're not dealing with bookless bandits. Don't suppose the answer came to you in a dream?
You just joined the Discord. Thank you, Game Earth Jen. That's a blessed place for people to find my most updated schedule, too.
Then you fell asleep. Too much ether, no doubt. Interesting. I hadn't considered the crystal. But of course, this changes everything. Oh, just thinking aloud. At any rate, we haven't a moment to spare. I must return and report this at once. I leave Lady Lilira in your capable hands.
How dare you pass me about like a swaddled babe? I shall return and tell them myself.
Okay, bye.
As you wish.
Gotta lurk and do some last minute work before you finish for the night. Yeah, good to see you too, Gamer Earth Jen. Thank you for the raid and thank you for stopping by. I appreciate the lurk. Have a great night and I'll see you around soon.
I suspect we shall meet again before long. Until then, do try and stay awake.
Sounds good. All right, let's fix these graphics, shall we? Is that even gonna be here? Display settings. Let's go down to 60. Michael, are you still here? Boop. Hi, Norza. How are you doing? No, you're not. Well, then, could the person who's sitting at Michael's keyboard tell me if changing it from the 120 to 60 should do the trick? I would think so, because I think that's what I'm streaming at. Fight something. Okay, thanks. I will fight several somethings. Seems like it's doing good. It looks Gucci. Thank you, friend. All right. Doing good. Okay. So let's go see what Papa Sean has to say. I'm not going to go too much longer, but we'll go until... I can't see how much time Raiders has right now. It's not ready to go, is it? Can't see what it says. Hang on. Oh, it is ready to go. Okay, hang on a second. I must have gone off in the... I think my sound for... Yeah, it should be announcing when a battle is ready, but I didn't hear it. Yeah, battle ready alert. I don't know why I'm not hearing that. I'll look into it later. All right. So 19 units on the field. Here we go. So I can hear that. You heard it? I can't hear it. But just that one, because I can hear the battle music. Weird. Oh, look. We won. And we'll do some random horror stones and Michael. Good job, guys. Thank you so much. It's probably going to be the last raiders I do, but let's go turn in the quest and just when next time we meet, which will be tomorrow after Michael's stream, so probably like 8 o'clock-ish Pacific, 8:30, we will start going down this bottom section here. So there is that. Let us go back to the game. And turn this in. Thank the gods you've returned. You had us all so worried. You do realize what would happen if a person of your noble stature were to be injured, or worse. Why, Her Grace the Sultana would be beside herself with grief, and so would her subjects. I dare say they'd be weeping in the streets. But I have already given you cause to weep, Papachan. You and the people of Uldah. Please, you're not to say such things. We will find it, I swear to you. It is not my place to make demands, m'lady, but I beg you, please, stay out of harm's way. I apologize for causing you undue worry, Papachan. I shall refrain from traveling unescorted in the future. I can't do accents either. So this will be entertaining. I love how they got a waddle because of their little hips. So round. I cannot thank you enough, Malorian. I understand you fought bravely to protect Lady Lilra from void-sent fiends. For your gallant service, you deserve all the riches in the royal vaults. Alas, a small token of my gratitude is the best I can offer. A sarcastic man with a strange contraption strapped to his shoulder? I see you met Thancred. He's a scholar who spends his days investigating oddities in the aether. Rather too fond of the sound of his own voice for my liking, but perfectly harmless. As for you, Malorian, you're just the sort of adventurer we need around here. I pray you show the same kindness to the people of Thanalan as you did to us today. Fleet. Oh, I didn't level up. I wanted to hear the sound one more time. There it is. Now I'm happy. All right, guys. I would call it for tonight. I had a long day with work and then doing the podcast with Beard in the Hair. Be on the lookout for that a week from Friday on his channel. Tomorrow night, check out Michael Fosbeck's channel starting at 5 o'clock Pacific. He's going to be doing, I assume, more Life is Strange or maybe Final Fantasy. I think he said he was going to do Life is Strange again. And then afterwards, I will be Life is Strange episode 2. Okay, yeah, was there 5 episodes for this one? So we'll be doing episode 2 for his stream. And then after he's done, I or around 8:30, whichever comes first, is going to be... I think I'm going to do a drawing stream. Maybe I'll do a game. Either way, we'll do Stream Raiders and we'll hang out and listen to music and go through some stuff. So we'll figure it out. We're going to be flexy this week. So let us see which of our friends we can send you off to. Who is streaming right now? Let's see. We've got... lots of people. Oh, D Green One Up and I'm assuming his wife are doing It Takes Two. And they are doing cosplay with their playthrough. So I really want you guys to see them. They are new friends. I met him through Robert Highwind. I think I think one of them raided the other, and I can't remember which was which. But, give me a second.
There, I did it.
But yeah, this is a, I believe a husband and wife, and they are playing It Takes Two. They're in, like, the winter area, and they actually are dressed up like the characters. So, D Green 1UP also does art streams. He does drawing, and he has a great vibe for his art streams, drawing with some music, and he's got the little avatars that you can personalize that run around the bottom of your screen. So go ahead and give him a follow. Show him some love when we get there. Thank you all for joining me tonight. This was a great stream. I love seeing so many friends come through, even if you can only just stop in and say hi and leave a lurk. I appreciate every single one of you. You make my day, and this is why I do what I do. So I will see you tomorrow. Have a great night. Get some good sleep and take care of yourselves. And I love you all. Good night. Awesome.